What's up, gamers? Jem here, and welcome to the first look for Watch Dogs Legion, and let's begin. So these are all like the just setting stuff that launches you as soon as you start the game for the first time. So let's hit confirm. Then you got image calibration, confirm again. I'm just going to leave that on default. Single player difficulty, I always do normal. But if you want to see the other settings, you have easy and hard. Then you have permadeath. You could turn it off, on, or Iron Man. You can read what that does in the description on the right side. So basically just means, if you're not aware, Watch Dogs Legion allows you to basically play as anyone you see in the open world, and with permadeath mode, if your character dies, they die forever. But if you play it off, then when you die, they don't die forever. It's probably going to be under a cooldown, I'm guessing, or maybe, yeah, I think it will be a cooldown. I think you'll have a few minute cooldown before you can play that character again, while you're forced to play someone else, is just my best guess. But anyways, let's start game. So I'm leaving on default, permadeath mode off, but to be fair, even if the default was on, I would have switched it to off anyways, because I want to play a game for fun. I don't really care about the challenge. And I also don't like the idea that I'm spending so much time on few characters that I might really enjoy and love, for them to die because I messed up. So I do like the ability to get them back. So this is somewhat a genuine first look. The last time I played this game was about 10 minutes, and then I gave up because of just this one setting that I will show you once we start this game, once it loads. But yeah, I did originally try to do a first look for this game when it was new, when it was launched. If this is a cutscene, I'm going to shut up.
Ah, London. What a town. History around every corner, and a tourist photographing it. Pubs serving up a pint and a smile. All that music, theatre and art. And multiculturalism. And the world's oldest underground, the Tube. The class of cities, really. Top shelf stuff. Only took 12,000 years to build it up, and one night to tear it all down.
What's our status?
Perimeter security's down, but plenty of your flying friends about.
Fucking hell.
Dalton, no time to waste.
Yes, ma'am. I'm in. Any idea what we're up against, Bagley?
If you haven't brushed off, I might. Ever consider leaving these security threats to the authorities?
That's rich, Bagley. The government would sooner arrest us for trying to help than actually do something useful.
Let us sort this one on our own.
Carefully, Dalton.
Bagley, are you detecting a little worry in Sabine's voice?
Brilliant. Asking the computer about feelings. This explains so much.
Shut it, you two, and get to work.
There she is.
So here we go. Like I said, I originally played this for about 10 minutes when I was doing the first look when this game was new, and the reason why I gave up and didn't bother uploading, well, actually putting the video live to public, is because I just really hated the game. And the reason why I hated the game so really quick was because of the lag. And no, it has nothing to do with Stadia. It's actually a game setting inside, which I only found out later after complaining on Twitter. So if we go into start, go into options, and then go into, I believe, gameplay, and this should be all the way down. Okay, it's not gameplay, my bad. It should be gameplay. Oh, is it on the gamepad? Okay, it's on the gamepad. And here we go. On foot sensitivity is set to 0%. I don't know why. I don't know why this feature exists. I don't know why it's at 0%. Why does this even exist? Anyways, first thing you should do is just put this at 100. And then your input lag problems will just go away. Now, I didn't even know a setting like this existed. And if I had known that before, I would have done this first look ages ago, months ago. But anyways, let's just make sure that just saved. Because sometimes you have to hit the save button to save. Okay, that did save. Nice. Nice. Now it feels great. Now I don't feel any lag whatsoever. It's perfect. Let's just play the game now.
That hurt you more than it hurt me.
So I haven't really gotten far. I didn't even finish the tutorial last time, so this is pretty much a genuine first look. Maybe like after 5 minutes. Actually, you know what? I just remembered. I actually quit right here, like on this spot. I didn't even get past this. let's press L1. Yeah, I don't actually remember this part. So yeah, this. So from now on, it is a genuine first look. I've never even seen this part. Let's hike that. So we can use R1 to attract. Oh, and distract. Takedown. Ooh. Oh, I remember liking the melee in this game, like the animations for like combos and stuff. It was really cool. Oops.
Over there. Come on.
Ooh, they got. I don't even know what block is or dodging. Oh, I managed to hit myself from that. Unlocked.
They've got loads of dead set gear down here. And why do you suppose that is?
What? How did they get their hands on it?
I don't know. But someone wants to make it look like dead set was here.
Shit. You need to proceed with extreme caution.
The threat to Parliament. Investigate the threat.
Who are these men in black anyway?
Nothing identifying. I suspect that's by design.
I don't know what the sprint button is. Oh, it's R2. And what is jump? Is it A? Yep. I believe this is where I'm supposed to be going. There's no mini map.
Okay. Oh, fuck me. The entire place is rigged to blow.
Jesus, ooh, those canisters.
So many bombs.
Bagley, is that?
RVX nitrogen. Enough to level Parliament.
Can you locate a detonator, Bagley?
Not exactly, but there's a device streaming a fuckload of encrypted data.
I've done the first
the
look for
you.
Watch Dogs 1 yeah, and 2 for Stadia. If you guys haven't checked that out and you're curious about
no,
the other Watch Dogs games, please
on the
do go check
us.
Those videos out. I love the Watch Dogs series. And I've came to the conclusion with the Watch Dogs series is that all three of these games are completely different from each other. Like, they don't feel like true sequels, and I don't even mean that as a bad way. They literally just all feel like unique standalone titles, just sharing the same world or same storyline, I guess. And you don't actually have to play the previous games to understand what's going on next. Like, the characters are new, the stories are new, but it's just like the organizations, you'll sometimes see them coming back. But you really don't need to play the previous games to understand the story of the new ones. But everyone who likes Watch Dogs they all have like that one favorite Watch Dogs game. It could be number one, number two, or number three. So for example, for me, now, like I said, this is pretty much a genuine first look on Watch Dogs 3. I haven't played the story, so I can't really speak much, and so far I haven't really seen the gameplay. But for me, comparing to 1 and 2, I like the gameplay on Watch Dogs 2.
These pricks are going to blow up Parliament and hang it on us.
Because
not if you get to that detonator first.
It's like more fun. They took like Watch Dogs 1 and they're like, let's actually make this fun. Not that Watch Dogs 1 wasn't fun. It's just like there's such a comparison between like gameplay fun mechanics between 1 and 2. So I like the gameplay of 2 much more than 1. But I love the story and the atmosphere of 1 more than number 2. And it's just, like, Watch Dogs series is just fantastic. Every game feels like its own unique thing. And then with Watch Dogs 3, you can be literally anyone you want in the open world. You just have to do a few missions. And can't wait to see how that works.
Right in the House of Commons. Whoever these men in black are, they've got brass bollocks to set up in the center of government.
Arm trap.
Found the detonator. And it's definitely live. Bagley, I'm gonna need some help with this.
Yes, you are, but sadly, I'm locked out.
Fuck. Well, we don't have a chance without Bagley.
Wait, I might know a workaround. We trained in manual overrides at MI5.
You're full of surprises.
Be quick about it.
All right, Bagley, do your thing.
I'm in. And the bombs have just armed themselves. Well, that may complicate matters.
Fuck's sake.
Can you defuse them or not?
Of course I can, but I might also trip another failsafe and vaporize you, so fair warning. I
expect this to draw some attention your way, Dalton.
Oh, I'm counting on it.
Company at our back door. Shit. Dalton, we've got some heat here at HQ.
How long is this going to take, Bagley?
Depends how often you interrupt me with questions.
All right, everyone. Faces on, guns out. It's about to get real.
Fuck.
So much swearing.
They're on me. I'll try and hold them off.
Okay, we can shoot now.
You may have to do this.
What does R1 do? What is this? It's a bomb?
Battery,
an EMP type of bomb?
Let's just say I'm both impressed and annoyed by how sophisticated anti-tamper security
is. I can't blind shoot.
Bagley,
I have to aim and
close.
Shoot.
I'm through security, now wading through terabytes of decoy code looking for the detonation sequence.
Okay, the shooting mechanics aren't bad. Oh, Y is to reload. But you can't, like, blindly shoot from cover.
I need some help.
Unless that's maybe like a player ability for some characters. Because with this game, every character has like a different ability from each other. So I'm thinking, what if one character has the ability to shoot from cover? Because right now I have to hold L2 in order to shoot.
Problem,
nope,
Dalton.
Worked.
I need your physical appendages now.
What does it want me to do?
What's wrong?
There are three slots on the left. One of them is the receiver. You need to pull the controller wire.
Are you fucking kidding me?
No, I'm fucking not. Pull the wire.
I believe Bagley's an AI.
If this gets me blown up.
I don't think I've ever seen AI swear.
Bombs defused. See? That wasn't so bad, was it?
Bagley, you bastard. You nearly gave me a bloody heart attack then. Whoa. What the fuck am I looking at?
It appears Parliament is not the only target.
More bombs are going live as we speak.
On screen, Bagley.
Now we need to get the word out. Those sites need to be evacuated.
They're spread out all over London. There isn't any time.
But my sister's at the town conference. We have to do something.
I picked up a transmitter on the roof that is sending out a signal to the other bomb sites. If you can reach it...
I can shut it all down.
I actually got upset for that guy who just died.
Fuck! Dalton, we're breached! Go! The roof!
Because he was caring about his family relative. And then he's the one who just dies. I don't know why, that just got me. I only knew the guy for like 2 seconds and it's already emotionally invested.
The protocol is to wipe everything, including Bagley.
I need him for the transmitter.
I know, but if they get him, they get everything. Names, ops, locations.
Press R3 to scan and reveal.
Okay, I'll do it the old-fashioned way. Wipe him.
Yes, wipe me.
I'm pressing
R3. Do it, Sabine,
R3,
and get the hell out of there.
What? Fuck.
Is it because I'm on the cutscene? Oh, I see.
Okay.
It's just a tap system, okay.
You're on your own. Dalton, if this goes...
It won't.
It's download.
I'll see you at the rally point.
Can I close and download? Oh, no, okay. Whoops. I hit the wrong button. I was wondering if it would just auto-download. But no, you have to have a hack device nearby. Hold character wheel. Ooh, I had an MP5 all this time. Could you imagine just James Bond swearing all the time? Yeah, there's no hip fire with this weapon either. Ooh, I like this weapon. Someone just yell out direct hit? Like we're in a video game? Okay, we arm the trap. I guess anyone who moves near it would just blow up. Oh, the London Eye.
Where are you?
Okay. Conveniently placed computer next to a satellite dish.
Some important work.
Important work? Killing thousands of...
Ooh.
Exactly. To save the world. You do know Londoners have died before, hmm? The plague, the Great Fire, the Blitz. There's not much fun. But destruction is always the cure. And it begins today. 0 day.
City.
Graphics look cool. Hard reset.
Oh my god. Damn. Hey, I turned permadeath off. I better be able to play that character later in the game. But but now it feels like it's part of the story.
A series of explosions devastated three sites in London. Authorities are asking residents to remain in their homes as the situation continues to develop. We have received no official casualty total, but it is expected.
Mourners gathered for a series of candlelight vigils that brought closure to thousands of families and indeed to an entire city. London is now laser focused.
And Downing Street, where Nigel Cass, CEO of private military company Albion, received a mandate to secure London. Cass has vowed to hunt down DedSec. Terrorist group responses may have forced. Albion used cutting-edge artificial intelligence systems and autonomous drones to capture the remaining members of DedSec. A stark warning to would-be insurgents.
Corporations are posting record profits due to increased efficiencies in production and distribution, enabled by the use of technologies initially developed and approved for security purposes.
It's a long overdue cleanup as crime numbers take a dive. Illegal gambling, drug trafficking and prostitution all down following prosecutions of the leaders of four of London's five largest criminal syndicates. The streets of Camden and Brixton.
Mandate is extended indefinitely by the government, life finally begins to return to normal. Curfews and travel restrictions have been lifted in all boroughs.
Love the guys just recording that in the background.
Reports of rioting in Trafalgar Square have been greatly exaggerated, possibly by foreign meddlers pushing a false narrative through social media. Albion is in complete control of a few...
...reprimand the public about the circulation of fake news. Conspiracy theories persisting in dark corners of the internet that terrorist group DedSec were framed for the bombs have been roundly rejected. Our own reporters could not find a single Londoner willing to expound those theories on camera. The facts simply don't support any other story.
We've got an achievement. And we're back on CTOS.
I need to assemble a team, but I can't reboot DedSec alone. Let me break into London CTOS and see who's available.
Hold L1.
I'm Claire Waters, and we've been discussing the hacktivist, now alleged terrorist group, DedSec, on this week's Buccaneer Radio. I have Colin.
Does this
calling
have double jump?
Colin,
or is it just me?
Take?
No, it doesn't have double jump.
Now, I've been saying from the start we should have rounded up DedSec and thrown them in jail. Now, I'll say they should all be lined up and shut.
You don't find it awfully convenient that they've been fingered as the attackers, but we've seen
walls.
No proof?
No, I
look
can't.
Look at Toe! Look at our city!
I mean, I'm literally a spider
well,
bot
Colin,
that can't
I'd
climb
say
on walls.
You have to look at their history of non-violent action. Albion's put more civilians in the hospital in the past few months than DedSec ever has. I smell a scapegoat. Now I have Emily calling in. Emily, what's your take?
You're absolutely
oh
right
my god,
there.
I nearly
the government's just
dropped down there. I thought I was supposed to go there.
They have this under control. They probably have no clue who was behind the bombings. But that doesn't look good on the news, does it? DedSec's been a thorn in their side. Who better to pin it on?
Angie, I have you next. What do you make of all this?
I think, if anything, DedSec showed their true colours. It's terrifying to think we harboured such a dangerous element for years. Terrorists in our own backyard.
Do you find DedSec more frightening than the different gangs in London like Clan Kelly?
Clan Kelly might set your shop on fire and maybe they'd kill you, but even they wouldn't try to blow up all of Parliament.
I'm just checking why I can't hold the R3 button.
Crypto King. Do you feel safer using a pseudonym?
Everyone should. Why make it easier for them to track you? And now we've seen what they're capable of and how far they're willing to go.
Hold on. Do you mean the government? Are you suggesting the government was responsible for the bombings?
Oh, trust me, Claire. They didn't do it alone. They're all in on it. The government, Albion, Sirs, Bloom, Sky Bloody Larson, and all the way up to Downing Street. They want to keep us scared, harness us with mind control, suck every last ounce of usefulness out of us, and even in death they'll set off our body.
Oh, I was interested in the talk.
situation is worse than I thought. But there's a candidate. Looks like you're Dead Sec's best hope.
Oh, we're literally selecting our first NPC to play as. We can see what the abilities are on the right side. As I said, the characters you play, they all have like one or two abilities, maybe even three abilities. Clothing discount, so you can play as this person and your ability is clothing discount. Although it is interesting if clothing discount is only for this character or would it apply to all my characters. So you got less, take less damage, shorter team arrest time. Oh, okay, so this one is team based, that's actually really cool. Drone summon, banned for life from London Zoo and pickpocket. But their special ability is carrying an MP5 apparently. But I like the little descriptions they have, so failed motorcycle license test but owns a motorcycle anyways. This one owns a sports vehicle. I'm also wondering if everyone here is randomly generated, so when you start this game new, do we all have the same list that I'm seeing right now, or is it actually randomly generated? Fast download, 6G data plan. You know what? I don't even know who to go for. I guess take less damage? Football player? Yeah, let's do it. Let's just do take less damage. So yeah, football players take less damage. Fun fact. Cool. Wow. That looks so cool. Oh my god, the graphics. It's really good. Honestly, if this game had VR, and I put in a VR headset right now, it would look so good.
Glad to see you're alive.
Wow.
If you're still committed to the cause, DedSec needs you.
I'm loving this.
I'll send you the coordinates to our last safe house.
It feels so realistic.
Sure.
But, there's just... You know what? No, I was going to say, there's less people on the streets than London normally has. But then again, I guess this is the pandemic version of London. At least I could pretend it is. Toggle music, let's turn that off. Auto drive, let's
go. Auto drive now enabled.
Is it not? Oh yeah, there's one way. Cool. That is so awesome. It just looks so real. Like Ubisoft has done their research. This feels like London. There's a double-decker bus. Actually, I need to figure out how to get the map. And then... Wait, untrack? I was already tracking? Oh, A to set waypoint. Yeah, I'm just gonna follow the waypoint. Now, in every Watch Dogs game, there is one thing they have in common, and that is bad driving. I don't know what it is. I don't know why they can't nail car driving. It does. The thing is, it does get better with each version of Watch Dogs. Like number one, Watch Dogs for driving, it is horrible. It is just straight up really bad. There's a huge learning curve just to get like the handling right into your muscle memory, and then 2 improves it a lot. And as I'm playing with 3 right now, it's still bad, but it's still definitely the best in the trilogy. Let's leave if I can figure
auto
out
auto drive now enabled.
Oh, I have to hold Y. I was tapping Y, I didn't know why I couldn't get out. Oh my god. Even the traffic light sounds. That's proper
I've
London.
I downloaded a patch to your optics so you can access our security system. It's set up so that I can't just let someone who isn't DedSec in. You'll have to do the manual override.
That is about what I was
expecting.
I do
like these mini-games.
Can't be too careful in times like this.
Okay. Let's just do that. Unlock.
One of Sabine's, are ya? I'll see you downstairs later then.
Into the safe house. What? Oh. I thought it was already unlocked, but you have to open it.
Good. Now let's see what we have.
There's a lot of like melee system in this game, so I guess like half the game could be just about being stealthy with melee and stuff. You got with the middle fingers.
Hello? Must be a way to get the power back on.
Okay, let's turn it on then. If I can figure out to get down there.
Buccaneer, this is the bug. Hello, resistors, it's bug time. Are you all sitting comfortably? No? Good, that's as it should be. This
is
the
underground
I'm Andy,
station.
Joining me to analyse the latest blowflies to emerge from the corpse of once free Britain, it's Alice.
Hello, Andy.
This is an underground station,
we're
going
to talk to you about Albion, your friends and mine. Alice, the government has extended Albion's contract and have also boasted that violent crime has plummeted to a record low. Now, extending Albion's contract, to me, that's like having a pet dog, let's call it Nigel for the sake of argument, that attacks you every single day and thinking to yourself, wouldn't it be nice if Nigel had puppies?
That contract has been extended so many times.
No DedSec registration detected. Identify yourself or I'll seal the exits, hack your optic and read you every drunken email you ever wrote until you starve.
Enough. I have clearance from Sabine.
Sabine's alive? Well, that's one piece of good news. I'm Bagley, DedSec's definitely not stolen, highly advanced AI assistant, and it seems I've been out of commission for a few months. Anyway, why don't you go connect me to the DedSec network so I can become more powerful than you could possibly imagine? I mean, catch up on what I missed.
I don't know why I can't interact with some things like that. I don't know how to interact with that. Maybe later in the game, but why is it shining now?
This could be useful.
A floppy disk. Oh, what's this? Oh, it's another.
Hello and welcome back to The Upload. In this episode, we're talking about CTOS 3.0, the city operating system that's now powering all of London. For those of you who need reminding, as if anyone does...
Ah, that's it. I'm reconnected to the network, downloading our database, news archives and... Oh!
I was listening to that CTOS 3, I want to know what it was.
Terrorist group DedSec responsible for deadly bombings in London. Dalton Wolf dead? I leave you people alone for a second and you immediately cock it all up.
The public thinks DedSec was behind the bombings, so who set them up?
There's a gap in my memory after Dalton, well, let's be honest, after I disarmed the bomb at Parliament. I'm missing information about what happened after I was taken offline. But from what I can infer, an unknown hacker group identified only as Zero Day was involved. I believe this Zero Day staged the attacks and framed DedSec for their dirty work. Come to my terminal. Sabine is requesting a video call.
Contact Sabine. Here, I guess.
Patching in Sabine Brandt now. I suggest you listen very closely to anything she has to say.
There you are. I'm glad you made it. Bagley, God, it's good to hear your demented little voice. Is your memory intact?
Not even slightly. The last record I have is of our HQ being raided. My only lead is a group known as Zero Day. Ring any bells?
No. But the HQ was attacked by some men in black, the same that were at Parliament. Maybe working together. We didn't stand a chance. They just gunned everyone down.
Definitely synchronized. How did you get out?
I managed to escape through the sewers to Camden.
A contact smuggled me out of the city, and I've been hiding out in the north since.
Prudent. Your profile is red flagged as a high-priority target in the city's surveillance system. Even a partial recognition here would have you hunted down and shot on sight.
And that goes for anyone who joins DedSec. I would like to have, but you're asking me to put everything on the line.
Listen, if anyone knows anything about risks, it's me. I lost everything and everyone. But it comes down to this. London is in a death spiral. And if DedSec can't pull it out, trust me, no one can. The city needs a resistance. And it starts with you. What do you say?
I don't think I have a choice.
You're right. I'm in. Let's get to work.
Excellent. New user registered. Welcome to DedSec. Now, it would be irresponsible of us to release you naked and mewling into the wild. You'll find equipment around the safe house that are essential items in your DedSec kit.
Oh, tech upgrades. So that's what that green thing is. Cool. Oh, I have a taser gun. I got 10 points. I can upgrade stuff right now. AR cloak. Camouflage to render invisible and break line of sight. Stealth based spider bots. I'd rather actually upgrade the weapons. New gadget in the tech menu. Whoops. A new gadget. Is it talking about the weapon diet? I don't even have the spider bot. Okay, so I don't even own it. I don't know what's better. Oh, the spider bot with double jump with 20 points. Fine, let's just buy this. I think it wants me to buy something. Yeah, it wanted me to buy it. Go to team menu, edit, gadget. There you go. It's cool that I can buy gadgets and swap them with characters.
We have a sophisticated system for hiding your identity from facial recognition tech. It's called a mask. And while we're here, perhaps we can talk about updating your wardrobe. I mean, look at you. Come on.
So we got like 375 pounds, but I don't think that is pounds. I don't know what currency that is. Do I have anything in my wardrobe? Miscellaneous. Yeah, sure.
You've got all these fancy new toys, but it's also important to know the basics. You need to learn how to throw a punch and how to take one. Albion will escalate if you come at them with a gun and shoot you down. We want to avoid collateral damage. In DedSec, we try to use guns only as a last resort.
Mate, you haven't met me. I'm wearing guns blazing. Give me that M25.
Oh. Some basic strikes.
Press X to attack.
Don't be shy.
Well, that was really quick training.
Under my block. Find the weak point. Nice one.
Okay, so why is to break the guard? I see.
Just like that.
Okay.
Quick on your feet now. You want to create distance.
Yeah, as I said like early in the video, there's like a lot of focus on meleeing, like there's these combo animations and stuff, it looks really cool. Ooh!
Yes. Nice.
Ooh! Kick to the face! Pow! Ooh!
Just like that.
Okay, I wasn't ready for that one. Ooh! I love that! Ooh! I felt that kick. It felt satisfying. Ooh. I wonder if it's always gonna go in slow motion when I need to dodge. Or if it's just doing that because it's training. Because the slow motion thing is really cool. Oh my god, I knocked her out. Oh my god. So the currency is called Eto. Or Eto.
Right, gear in order? Know enough not to punch yourself in the face or get shot for pulling out a gun too early? Brilliant. I'm working out how we find Zero Day and ruin their day, but I need someone with actual legs to do the legwork. Hope you're ready.
What is this? Okay. What? I'm gonna leave? I don't know what that is. It's weird. There's actually a DLC in this game where you can play as Aiden Pierce and do his story. And Aiden Pierce is a character you play as on Watch Dogs 1, in case you didn't know. I want to, like, just recruit someone. I hope we get that mission next.
Alright, take it easy.
Oh, we can start recruiting.
Okay, let's get started.
Make no mistake, London is under occupation.
I can literally recruit anyone.
Armed mercenaries patrol our streets, allegedly to keep people safe, but really they're keeping the people scared.
That's Albion's plan. Much easier to trample people's freedoms when they fear everything. They never even see it.
So, we have to ignite the will to resist in the people of London by showing them that Albion aren't the solution. They're the problem.
Hey, for that, we'll need information.
I'm pushing two sets of coordinates to your optic.
Cheers, Bagley. I've identified two opportunities.
Oh my god, I pulled out a gun by accident. How do I take
remind
it?
The people it's not Albion's way on the highway. Two,
how do I put my weapon
need
back?
We intel about Albion operations if we want to throw a spanner in their plans. You game?
Yes. This is what I'm here for.
Oh, there we go.
Brilliant. Let's get the people of London
that was
on
an
board.
Accident. All I wanted to do was just, yeah, scan people, and I hit the wrong button.
Well, that's it. Ending search.
Drone summon. I wonder if I recruit someone who has a gadget that I haven't even bought, I wonder if, like, it counts as me buying it, and then I can trade it. Megaphone, rally people to fight. Bandana gas immunity. That is so cool. Dark gun.
Just fucking fantastic. Brilliant.
This is not a choice.
Let's actually recruit someone. I think the game will let me. Team arrest, release, extra melee damage. Save to recruits. Wait, start recruitment. Oh, actually. Let's do save to recruits, potential recruit, and then recruit track, recruit Pam. So
what
I
can you tell me on these girl bags?
Looks like she's a marked woman. Clan Kelly put a bounty on her head.
Why?
She's an underground bare knuckle boxer, a rather good one too. She managed to take down a mob backed favorite in her last match. Now they're sending out an enforcer to make sure she never wins again.
Those cowards don't know the meaning of a fair fight. Bagley, help me track down that enforcer.
Already done.
So to recruit Pam, we have to do something for her. But it's not like I even talked to her, it's just we're doing it in the background. I need a car. Is there a way I could spawn a car? Oh, I think I need to actually have one of those characters that says you have a motorcycle or a car. Oops. Is it always going to pull out my weapon? I'm just trying to think. Oh. Oh, it's emotes. Okay then. So this is weird. Holding the up button opens the weapon menu. Holding the right button opens the weapon menu. Holding the down button opens the menu. So I think it's just for quick switch. Yeah. So up is to pull out your weapon. Down's for melee. And right doesn't do anything at the moment, but I think it's to, like, maybe activated gadgets, perhaps, if I had one. I know I have the R1 ability, but maybe like a way to cool a car if I had a car. Anyways, you know what, let's get the motorbike. Let's see what motorbike riding is like in this game. And I crashed. Story of my life. Oh my god. wrong button. Let's go to the map. Oh, we have to go all the way down here. Let's go. And let's enjoy the sightseeing of London. Look at that. There's an advertising on London Eye. Oh my god, I want to check. Hold on, I want to check down here. It's not that long ago since I've actually been literally here. Let's try and leave. I want to see how accurate it is. Okay. So, it's so awesome that I'm just like, just visiting London from where I'm sitting. I love it. So you can shop stuff here. Oh, there's a teddy bear. There's nothing really that I want. Yeah, I'm good. So, usually they're supposed to be... So if this was real life, there's supposed to be an aquarium. Which I wonder if it's this. Play. Keep up tutorial. Oh, you can play like... Keep ups. Yeah, it's your tutorial. Oh, I thought there was going to be a tutorial, but it's just telling you what to do.
Let's just say this is physical coordination training. I'll keep track of your score.
Oh, okay. It's just quick time event. Oh, it's just R2 and L2? Okay, let's just do this again. I feel like I'm going to mess it up at some point. Awaiting area crime report. So, if you get to the green part to do a combo... Oh my god, it's an L1. That L1 just came out of nowhere. I thought it was just L2 and R2. I wasn't ready for that. But yeah, there's supposed to be an aquarium here. Which I think it's probably like these dolphins, it's to mark the aquarium. But from what I remember, there is no like going up. Oh, here is this is the aquarium. Cool. So they got the aquarium in this game. But I don't remember in real life the aquarium having stairs to go up like this. I might be remembering it wrong, it's just that I don't remember something like that. But it is cool that they did add an aquarium. Because I know there's an aquarium there, because I went there before a few years ago. It's just so cool. Oh my god. I love this. And then there should be a skate park, if I keep going forward. I wonder if they added the skate park, but it's gonna be quite a long walk, unless it's this. I think. Whoops. Uh oh. Leave me alone. What the hell? I think that is the skate park. But it's just like taken by another like team. Oh well, you know what? I'm just gonna take this bike. Should turn off the music again. I'm just sightseeing London. This is what I wanted to do when the game launched anyways. I just wanted to go, just drive around, seeing how accurate London is. It's not bad. It's not a bad representation. It's definitely not a bad representation. It's not 100% accurate. I would say maybe about 50%. Like, I think they had to, like, make a smaller version of London. So they had to, like, remove some stuff, change the level design a little bit to make more sense to whatever game they had in mind. But so far, I like it. I like what I'm seeing. Let's just see if we can recruit someone.
The enforcer we're after is here, currently enforcing some poor bastard's head into the pavement. If you take them out, our boxer friend may live to fight another day.
Can I... need like... Oh, well, I could probably climb this. Now, I can't tell if this person is a part of the gang or an random NPC. But I guess we'll never find out. can I not hack this? Oh, is this not hackable? Let's hijack this. I wanted to figure out how to... Yeah, there we go. Yeah, I want to go here. So you can't... I can't hack from this.
What the heck? Seriously? Oh, forget this.
Oh my god! What the hell was that? I didn't even press a button. I just dropped down and it automatically did that. That's awesome. I can't pick up this gun? Oh, is it because characters need to learn, like, how to shoot a gun?
Blood! We got trouble!
Blood, we got trouble. Yo, what's up?
Well done. I'll have a trophy pow, set pow, pow.
Oh my god! Oh, I'm Batman! Ooh! Oh my god, the fly kick! I touched the fly kick! Oh my god. Okay, I'm low on health already. I'm low on health. Oh my dude, that guy just leaped onto me. I'm out. Are they shooting me? Who the hell is shooting me? What the hell is shooting me? Okay, that's it. You're shooting me, I'm taking out my gun. It's a taser, but it will do. Oops, hit the wrong button. I think it does headshots. Whoa! That just team killed. That wasn't me.
There, that takes care of the immediate mortal peril. Now, Scarlet, I'll kill you for sure.
I don't even get what that is. That's a news drone. I can disable it. Oh, that's what I did in the first place. Escaped area. Okay, I will escape. I don't even know where my health bar is, but I think it's one of those games where it's about... Actually, you know what? I do actually have cloak. I have cloak. Let's go! It doesn't make sense in real life, but let's go with it. Get to safety.
We did a good job.
Don't break out the tiny party hats just yet. We might have bought our boxer some time, but once Clan Kelly finds out what happened, they'll almost certainly want revenge. Suggest you warn her.
I'm on my way.
Okay, so now we go for Pam. If I can actually hit the map button. and they're up there. So it's really cool that I can see where a random NPC that I saw before was. And that's another thing with this game. Every NPC you see here, they all have their like working schedules. So like, if you want, you can literally just stalk an NPC, see where they go, if they go home, if they got work to go to. Apparently, they go based on like the time of the day, so it's like the same always. But don't quote me on that, that's what I've heard. But if true, that is so cool. Because that's what Skyrim and Red Dead does, and Watch Dogs Legion just takes that to the next level, because there's just so many, like thousands and thousands of NPCs there. And just the idea of recruiting anyone you see is just such a brilliant idea. And it's a good execution so far, I like it. And I like that every NPC you want to hire has a mission to do. And it's like unique, not unique, but it's tailored to their personality and description. Like there's a connection. It's not just a really random mission. It's connected to whatever the NPC's like personality is and what they're doing as a career, maybe. Okay, so they are like in the shopping area.
You might want to hurry. I'm detecting some Clan Kelly movement in the area.
So there they are. Let's talk.
Hello. I'm afraid your fighting has put you in danger.
What do you mean?
Clan Kelly is upset that you won. It cost them money. Now they want you dead. We stopped the enforcer they sent after you, but they are sending more.
Interesting. This will be good practice for in the ring, won't it?
It is obvious that you can handle yourself, but there are too many in this case. Find shelter. We will draw their attention.
Right. Thank you. I most certainly owe you one for this.
The voicing is so bad. It's cheesy. I'm sorry, but both of these characters have bad voicing. And I believe it's like AI voiced. I remember reading somewhere where there was actually only like 11 voice actors used and the rest is done by AI. With the voice actors to be different, but the execution isn't well, it's really cheesy. It just... No. Is there someone behind you? Oh no, I hit the wrong button. No. No, just... There we go. Oof. Dude, that guy's got a shotgun. That guy's not playing around. Okay, I need to heal. Come on. Oh, they're out. So they actually can go out of ammo. Nope, they lied to me.
That does it. Get somewhere safe so we can contact our fighter.
Are you alright?
I'm fine. Christ. I knew the Kellys were bastards, but not this petty. There's no concept of a fair fight left in this town.
People like us, with particular skills. We have a responsibility. You should join that sec.
Fine. I'm in.
Yay. We've recruited them. You know what would be really cool? If everyone you recruit, right, it would be so cool if they actually continued living their lives in the map and I can see where they are on the map.
More badass folks like you should join us. If you know anyone.
Yes, well, I'm ready to help however I can.
Great.
That would encourage me to get like 100 recruits or whatever the max number is. And just like, just, it's so cool to just see your character just walking down the street. And just... But yeah, like I like the idea that my characters can just walk down the street and I can just go past them and see them on the map. But yeah, now we're playing this character. So this character has a cloak as well. I think that's because of me. Oh, we could down a pint. Let's do that. Let's down a pint.
Ha!
And what did what does that do? Down a pint and become drunk. Can I do it again? How drunk can I get? Huh? What is that noise? Ran over my car. Why is it sound keep coming to my left? Can I just randomly start beating up people? Oh my god, yes I can. Oh my god. Are they dead? Injured and hospitalized by Operative Pam Downey. Oh my god. And then they got like two thumbs down. Heading to hospital to recover. Oh my god, no way. Are we actually going to see someone? Oh, Operative. Oh, that's the person I recruit. So you can see them in the street. Oh, that... Okay, I like that we can actually genuinely see them on the street like that. But I want them to appear on the map. Like, I would love for them to appear on the mini-map as well, just to see where they are. Unless they just randomly spawn, like, every minute or something, that's cool too. I love the idea that I can just see. And you can see it quite clearly as well, like, they've got, like, a green player icon next to them. So if I went close to them, what can I do with them? Nothing? I can view and team, I can distract. So it said they're heading to the... Oh, there's the paramedic. Trying to help Ty Brush. Oh my god, is that the person we just... That is... I love that. It's just telling you what they're gonna do. That is Ty Brush. Oh my god. Wait, is he a CTO? CEO? Oh. Hack still.
Global British Broadcasting. Britain's first news network.
You all right?
Digital privacy advocate. Oh, she's not like a.
This area is being
by the like a doctor. It took me so long to remember that word. I was gonna say healer.
What happened?
Well, the NHS is taking their time. I don't think anyone's coming. Heading to hospital to recover. And then POW! Oh my god, just came out of nowhere! And then heading to hospital to recover. You turn that off. There's so many drones. What can I do to this? No, come back down. I can't do anything to this. Heading to nest to eat. I can just see myself just following random NPCs just to see where they go and stuff. That's so cool. Recent purchase. Hemorrhoid cream. Can we go in here? Ah, we can't. Shopping at Daisy Do until 1 p.m. Yes, this is Daisy Do. Same per. Oh, for this person as well until 1 p.m. Oh, and there's like, it's 12:21 right now. And I have no doubt that they will leave at like 1 p.m. Oh, can I go in now? Well, the door's open, but I can't go in. No one's helping them. Oh my god. So cool. Ah, just took out my gun again. By accident. What is this? Deliver. Parcels. Okay. No, I'm good.
The demands of being a DedSec operative are all consuming. So, taking app gigs is a good way to make some extra quid that works around your new schedule. Lots of people will pay well to have their sensitive packages handled with care. And some will even pay for deliveries.
This is Albion's car. That's so cool. Oh my god. Oh my god, no! It's gonna hit me. Oh my goodness.
Begin a search.
Oh my god, yeah. This is why I don't have my driver's license. But yeah, see how many people can run over. Yeah, no one's gonna join DedSec after this. Oh my god. Boom! Ooh. Oh my god. It's really cool. So there's a choir mission nearby. You know what? I want to also, I want to go into this. Wait, no one's driving this. Cool. And there's like news drones just continuing to follow me, but this. It doesn't. Is there no like wanted system in this game, or is it just being very generous because I'm new? Because like I've killed so many people, I ran over so many people. Literally no consequences. No one's chasing me. In Watch Dogs 1, it had first-person camera mode, but I have a feeling this game doesn't have that. Just didn't even like jump out, it just looked out. Oh, I know where I am. Oh, I love that traffic light sound. But yeah, I think I'm just gonna end the video here. I'm also gonna do a PS5 first look of this game, and I'll focus on the missions on that one. This one was my pretty much a genuine first look. I really wanted to explore the city, I wanted to see how recruiting people worked, and you know what, I have no idea how you switch people. I have a feeling, you know what, I have a feeling you switch by just doing this. Yeah. Right? Oh, show on map? You can see people on the map! Oh, that is so cool, but it's not like... Oh, I can waypoint. Oh, you can only see them if you select to see them. Okay, you can see these people on the map. Okay, that is cool. I like that. But it's just, it's not always. It's not 24/7. You have to manually select it. But you can waypoint there. Okay, I like that. That's cool. But also, you can actually just switch to them by pressing X on there. Okay, I like that. That's what I wanted. I said it'll be so cool if I could see them on the map. Turns out you can, but you have to select them manually. But yeah, at least that feature even still exists. So I like the idea that they really are just going around London doing their own thing and living their lives. That's so cool. But yeah, so I will be doing a first look of this on the PS5 as well. I'll be focusing more on the first few missions of that, which I wanted to do in this video, but I got so into just visiting London from the comfort of seeing my home in London. It's just, I like this. Ubisoft has done a great job at recreating London, definitely 100%. It's really good. I like this. But yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching my video. This is Jam, and I'll see you on the next one.